And I would like, on behalf of our study group, I would like to present the works of our group, the practice of CBD measurement of physicians who attended the CBD days at Ho Chi Minh City. And this is the outline of my presentations. And so why we need to do this study, because we know that we had the guidelines and the GOLD guidelines and GOLD HAMAX very strong and clear recommendations on the treatment of CBD. But the fact that we in Vietnam, we still do not know how the physicians prescribe the drugs, how they practice CBDs, do they follow the guidelines. So we carried out this study to investigate the current practice of CBD measurements in outpatient settings of those who, doctor, the physician who attended the CBD days last year at Ho Chi Minh City. And this is the retrospective observational study, and we have the convenience sampling, which includes all the participants who attended the CBD meeting last year, and so we do not have the sample size calculations for this study. And we use the structure questionnaire to interview the participants. And the questionnaire had five sessions, including the demographics, the science, the resources of the working place of the subjects, and the training received on CBD, and the knowledge and attitude of CBD, and the practice of my CBD. But in today, I always present for the demographics and demography and the practice of CBD. And we have very simple inclusion criteria on the participant, on the physician who attended the CBD day meeting last year were included in the study, and who went to answer our questionnaires. And we give 250 questionnaires, but only one third of them will respond. And when we make statistical analysis, only 85 were eligible. And this is the questionnaire. We have a lot of information here. It's about the information, the photographs, and the drugs, and the training for CBD, and the drug available, and the technology and attitudes, and a lot of information. And for the results of our studies, for the 18, I'm sorry, for the 18 and 5 who analyzed, about half of them were male, and the average age attends very young, only 31, and about one-fourth of them were pulmonologists, and the rest was the other doctor, family doctor, or internist, or other specialist. And this average years of practice of the physician who the average years of practice involving the lung disease for the pulmonologist were about 10 years, and for the other doctor were about 6 years. So we can assume that they might experienced doctor. And for most of them, about 90% work at the public sector and 10% work at the private sector. And so this is the level of the working place. About 10% they work at the central level, and half of them work at the city or urban levels, and the rest work at the lower level, district or the web level. And for the number of CBDs, based on the doctor, see it works. I think it's quite about, you can see the percentage here, only about 10% see more than 100 CBD patients per week, and most of them, 90% see less than 100 CBD patients per week. And the number of patients with the medical insurance who were managed by the doctors, about 80%. This is quite high. With the maximum 100%, I don't know why it's 100%, and the minimum be 5%. This may be from the private sector. And so this is the availabilities of the medication during the last years. We have the three categories, the only available, and sometimes they are available for the treatment, and the medication were not available. And we can see a lot of medication here for the ICS and ICS level. We can see more than it's about 80% of the ICS level has available or sometimes available. But for the LABA and LAMA, we can see all LABA and LABA and LAMA, all the combination of LABA and LAMA, we can see about only from 1.4 to 1.5 of the LABA and LAMA were available, only available, and sometimes available is the same percentage. So we can see that the viabilities of the medication might affect the prescription, the practice of the doctor, because in the study for the city level and the central level account for 60%, but we expect the higher the percentage of availability for medication, but it is a little bit low. And OCS is ongoing available for on the level. And so the other, this is other medications. And we just add them, did they use biometrics for the diagnosis of CBD? And we're very lucky that 100% of the lung doctor, they answer yes. And for the other specialties, only 70% were used the spirometries for the diagnosis of CBD. So this might, we might need to improve this one. And why we, when we classify the CBD patient into group A, B, C, D, and so you can see here, I don't know why about 1.4 of the doctor they still use the comorbidity to classify the CBD patients, and some of them they only one say that they do not classify the CBD patients, and so this field we need to improve. And so this is the preferred choice for maintenance therapy of the CBD patient in the outpatient setting, and we can see the ICS use as two commands in among the group A, group B, group C. You can see it's about 10% to 50% are still prepared ICS and LABA. And this might be due to the availability of the drugs at the up there at the hospital. Some doctor they still use the ICS LABA for the patient. They think that the patient have very severe, but they do not use to follow the guidelines. And so for the conclusions of the study, so several CBD medications are not available in operation settings, and spirometrics were underused by non-pulmonologists. And some classification criteria for CBD may be used in broader at least, and the maintenance therapies might be improved. Maybe due to the availability of the drugs, not due to the knowledge of the doctor. And this one, we need to persuade the hospital and the medical insurance to cover and to have the drugs available for the doctor. And thank you for your attention. And I would like to thank all the doctor who participated in our study.
Okay, thanks so much.